Morning, everyone. I'm Jessica Corbett, Director of External Affairs for Fulton County. Thanks to all of you for being here today. We have some folks who are also viewing the live stream of this press conference. We're first going to hear from Fulton County Chairman Rob Pitts, followed by Registration Elections Director Richard Barron. They're joined this morning by our County Manager Dick Anderson. I just want to thank everyone for being here, and we'll go ahead and get started.
Good morning, and thank you for being with us again today. I'm Rob Pitts. I chair the Board of Commissioners of Fulton County. I'm joined by our County Manager, Dick Anderson, as well as our Director of Registration and Elections, Richard Barron. This is the second day, what is scheduled to end on Wednesday at midnight. Good news, we have, based upon and due to the hard work of county employees and others who stepped forward to help us with this effort, which we did not anticipate, we are finishing in record time. If you were here yesterday, you saw a beehive of activity behind me. But look at it today. I'm happy to report that we are finishing way ahead of schedule with respect to the hand counting of the individual ballots. The individual ballots will have been completed, the hand counting, rather, of the individual ballots will have been completed, and they are being uploaded into a system that will go to the state. To date, as of my walking over here, we have uploaded some 100,000 already that are going to the state where they will be tallied. So it's all due to the hard work of the employees, Fulton County employees, the other volunteers that we had, the work of our county manager and his team, the work of our director of registration and elections. But the bottom line is Fulton County, again, has risen to the top, and we have completed the assignment that we were given, the unexpected assignment that we were given by the Secretary of State to become involved in this manual recount of all votes that were cast on November 3rd. So with that as an introduction, I'd like to bring up Rick Barron, our Director of Registration and Elections, to go into a few more details, and the three of us will be happy to entertain any questions that you may have.
Good morning, everybody. We have distributed all the work. There are approximately 30 teams still left working. We've had as many as 170 teams working. The original math given to us by the state said that if we had 248 two-person teams, we should be able to finish it in 8 hours. I think the bulk of the work that is left on the tables is almost complete. And so I don't know what time it was. I don't want to give an exact time, but it should be early afternoon. We should be concluded at least with the hand tally of this audit of the presidential race. We were given one sign-in in the software that allows us to enter each batch, and every county was only allowed one sign-in. Evidently, the company Arlo that the state is using, they made a change to the software last night, so we can have multiple users now. That's the backlog, is getting all those bat sheets. For a county the size of Fulton to have one sign on, when you have a county such as Banks, which has about 10,000 registered voters, they have one sign on it. It's much harder for us to get all those bat sheets entered in a timely manner. So hopefully we'll catch up with that today. And then we'll audit those. We'll get those bat sheets over to the state. We have to copy those and transmit those to the state. And essentially, other than the data entry, by early afternoon, we should be complete with everything here. I can take any questions. Well, I think it was the number of teams. Between what the county was able to recruit from county employees, and then we also recruited poll managers that worked in the November election. We had at one point 340 people, 172 man teams, and I think it was just the number of tables that we had set up and the number of people. That was how we were able to do this. And as you can see, we've got a big facility behind us, so we were able to space the tables out, get everything out there and distribute the work. And I think as after the early morning yesterday, when people started getting used to the procedures, then they were able to get through it much quicker. Well, what happens is we get the batch sheet that's done, and those batch sheets, they don't correspond necessarily. We went through all the absentee, we went through all of the early voting. There's still some early voting ones, because those were the biggest batches, and then the election day. So we just enter those batch sheets as we enter them. They don't necessarily correspond to the precincts, and we don't have a running total in Arlo. All the data entry we do is entered, and then it's uploaded to that state site, and so they have the numbers. I expect that the hand count is going to come out different than the machine count. I mean, it's just the nature of the way this works, because when you have machines looking at something and then you have humans looking at something, there's going to be a difference in the count. I don't expect the margin or the overall result to change. I just think that the individual numbers will change. We have two elections on December 1st to conduct. One of those elections, Congressional District 5, that's already underway. We've started early voting last Monday for that. Senate District 39 will begin on November 23rd for early voting, and then we have to run those elections separately on November 1st. So there'll be two check-ins, December 1st. We'll have two check-ins, two sets of equipment. It'll be run as two separate elections. There's a Senate District 39 Democratic primary runoff, and then Congressional District 5, which is to finish out the term from the late Congressman Lewis, and that term will end in early January or the end of the year. And then the new representative will take over in January for that race. And then January 5th, we will have the two U.S. Senate races and a Public Service Commissioner race. I think what we will transmit everything to the state, and we'll allow the state to release that. Well, what you're going to have, especially the early voting batches were larger than the batches that were in absentee. And so if you're in an area, if you're walking by tables and you see a disparity, that early voting site may have been down in a heavily Democratic area. And that's why you're going to see that sort of imbalance. For this hand tally? Well, I mean, what we do when we get a ballot in is we compare that signature to what's in ElectionNet, which is essentially Department of Driver Services. If there is no match for the signature, or if a signature doesn't exist in ElectionNet, which is the state's voter registration system, then we go to the original voter registration application, which we store in the images in another file, and then we'll go to that to compare the signatures. Once a ballot goes through signature verification, that ballot is then separated from from the envelope. Therefore, there's no way to it would be a waste of time to verify the signatures on the ballots now. They've already been verified through the process that we had before, and then those ballots no longer are paired with those envelopes. Yes. I don't know, was that for statewide or for Fulton County? I don't know what our rejection rate was in Fulton County, but that sounds really high. So I can't comment on other counties' rejection rate. Whatever the state directs us to do with regard to that, we'll do that. How has this experience been doing this hand tally? Well, I think that we did it as efficiently and quickly as we could, given the amount of time we had to put it together. We were preparing for a risk limiting audit on Thursday, which probably would have pulled 200 to 250 ballots. We found out on, I guess it was Wednesday, that we were gonna do a full hand tally of 520,777 ballots, and that's quite a difference from 200 to 250. To put this together that quickly was onerous, but we were able to, through the help of the county, get this facility and get it organized and make sure it happened. I mean, it was, I think all of my staff is tired. I don't remember, they probably don't remember the last time they had a day off, so it's, but we made it happen, and I think we're going to be finished ahead of schedule. My goal was to get done by close of business Monday, and I think the only thing we could be working on tomorrow is some data entry, but I hope we get that concluded today as well. We haven't received any reports of that. I would imagine if we do a full machine recount, we'll probably conduct it in a similar way, but it'll be on scanners instead. We will only have access to the 7 that we have, so it's going to take significantly longer to do a machine recount than it would be to do this. Well, we'll probably pull them out in the same, they'll pull them out in the same batches that they've been done in and do it that way. Yeah. Anything else? Well, we did recruit some poll managers, but I think part of it has to do with the budget. I mean, this is an expensive endeavor that's falling to the counties. So we made the decision to use as many county employees as we can to reduce the costs that we would have to pay. All right, thank you.